Jeff Bezos, the billionaire who gained an extra $77 billion throughout the pandemic so far, has a couple things to say about President Biden recently saying that corporations and wealthy individuals need to pay their fair share in taxes. So in case you haven't been following along, President Biden did say that recently on Twitter, you know, how do we deal with inflation? Well, we get the wealthy to help pay their fair share in taxes. Is that going to solve all of inflation here in the United States? It definitely is not. But I will get to in a minute how that actually does help with inflation. But Jeff Bezos took issue with this. So he decided to pull an Elon Musk and become a massive Twitter troll. And in one of the tweets that he sent in response to Biden's claim that the wealthy are not paying taxes, which clearly set Bezos off, Bezos praised Joe Manchin for killing Biden's agenda. Let me read this one tweet from Bezos here. The administration tried hard to inject even more stimulus into an already overheated inflationary economy, and only Manchin saved them from themselves. Inflation is a regressive tax that most hurts the least affluent. Misdirection doesn't help the country. Now, in one of the tweets, he did go on to talk about, yeah, we can have a conversation about, you know, the wealthy paying their fair share in taxes, but how dare you link it to inflation? Well, I'll tell you how. In fact, I don't need to tell you how, because Bernie Sanders has actually sponsored legislation that really lays it out pretty well. And I think this is kind of what Biden was hinting at, even though he didn't say it so eloquently. The fact is, corporations like Amazon, Mr. Bezos, have been price gouging consumers for several years, mostly due to the pandemic, right? There is a supply chain shortage, not just in the United States, actually, it's global. So all these people who think, oh, we're suffering here in the United States. Yeah, get in line, folks. It's happening all over the planet. Inflation happening all over the planet. Why don't you open your eyes a little bit and look beyond our borders and see that this is not a unique problem to the United States. It was not caused by Biden. It was caused by a pandemic. So anyway, what these corporations have also done is they're price gouging consumers. They're artificially inflating the already inflated prices. So Bernie Sanders comes along and he says, all right, we're going to put in place a windfall tax. That's what his legislation wants to do. Of course, people like Manchin aren't going to let it become a reality. But he says this windfall tax is basically going to tax you at 90% on all of your profits that are above pre-pandemic levels. So not even all your profits. If you made $500 billion prior to the pandemic, but then you made $600 billion after the pandemic or during the pandemic, only the $100 billion difference would be taxed at that higher rate, because that, folks, is the price gouging portion of it. So yes, if we tax these price gouging profits, corporations would have more incentive to stop the price gouging. So what would that do to prices for consumers, folks? It would lower them. So yes, I know it's a little complicated to explain, and it's difficult, you know, damn near impossible to do that in a single tweet to somebody like Jeff Bezos, whose company paid zero taxes in 2017 and 2018. But that's the answer. So yes, paying your fair share in taxes would in fact help inflation. Is it going to solve all the problems? Absolutely not. But is it going to solve a little bit of it? Definitely. And that's what Bezos is so scared of. He doesn't want to pay more. Let me read this. Amazon is the best actor of tax avoidance, meaning of all the companies that do tax avoidance, Amazon doesn't do it to the degree that some other companies do. They paid a 12% effective tax rate between 2010 and 2018, in contrast with 30% corporate tax rate in the US during the same period. So the tax rate was 35%, they only paid an average of 12% for that 9-year span. Without tax breaks, they would have paid an additional $7 billion per year for each of those 9 years from 2010 through 2018. So Bezos is sitting there whining about Biden's claim, knowing damn well that his company is benefiting from tax breaks that they clearly don't even need. And even if you took away their tax breaks, they would have only paid a 21% tax rate instead of the 35% tax rate. So what are you whining about, man? Even if we took away most of your tax breaks, you're still paying a lower rate than most Americans. Bezos is just another whiny billionaire that doesn't want to spend any more money paying taxes.
What are you doing? It's over. The video's over. I'm done complaining about everything, and that's it. The end. Leave. Well, okay, if you're going to stick around, maybe you should give us a like, a comment, a share, or just subscribe to stay connected with all of our content. Or maybe you should consider becoming a member for some exclusive content and perks. Just follow the link in the description. Now, go. Just go.